Finding the best camera for YouTube is the ideal way to take your channel up a notch or finally get one started. Your smartphone might just be good enough for shooting YouTube videos, but having a dedicated camera will radically improve the quality of your content, both in terms of video and audio. We've selected the best YouTube cameras for this video, and while there are a few high-end premium cameras, there are also budget models designed for beginners who don't have a lot to spend. Different types of YouTubers will have different needs. We've listed the top 5 cameras for YouTube and their key features, plus the things you need to consider to help you choose the best one for you. Links to all products mentioned in the video are in the description below. You could also find a more detailed analysis and a comparison tool on our website validconsumer.com. Number 5. Sony ZV-1. If you prefer the convenience of a built-in lens, the Sony ZV-1 is the best point-and-shoot we've tested for YouTube. While you don't get as much flexibility with a fixed lens, it's an easier jump from using smartphones since you don't have to worry about buying and learning about different lenses, which is good news for those looking for the best camera for YouTube beginners. The lens on this thing has a decently wide aperture, meaning you can get some fairly nice bokeh out of it, and there's even a dedicated background defocus button to quickly toggle between a shallow depth of field and a wider depth of field. The other big advantage of the ZV-1 is that it's more compact than an interchangeable lens camera, although not as portable as the GoPro Hero 9 Black. It's essentially a smaller Sony ZV-E10 with a fixed lens, and just like that camera, it has a fully articulated screen, a large dedicated record button, and a microphone optimized for vlogging, complete with a detachable windscreen to reduce ambient noise. Just be aware that a smaller camera means a smaller battery and shorter battery life, along with a tendency to overheat during longer recording sessions. If that's not a deal breaker, this is one of the best YouTube cameras with a fixed lens compact design. Number 4. Fujifilm X-S10. The Fujifilm X-S10 is the best 4K camera for YouTube that we've tested. This mirrorless APS-C camera is Fujifilm's first dedicated vlogging camera, and it packs tons of features at a reasonable price point. With an autofocus system that can keep up remarkably well in video, and a high frame rate mode in 1080p for slow motion recording, it's a super versatile camera for a range of video work. It's fit for walk and talk vlogs thanks to its fully articulated screen, as well as videos that require more of a studio setup. In-body image stabilization helps smooth out camera shake when shooting handheld, and the camera feels great in the hand. Its biggest downside is battery life, which is a bit limited compared to some competitors, and it can sometimes overheat when recording continuously for long periods. If you're shooting shorter takes, however, it's manageable, and the camera supports use while recharging via USB, which is handy if you have a portable battery pack. If your ambitions lie beyond YouTube, you might prefer a filmmaking beast like the Panasonic Lumix GH5II, which has better internal recording capability and offers more recording formats and codecs. However, it's probably overkill for most aspiring YouTubers, and the Fujifilm makes for an easier entryway into video for those just starting out. Number 3. Sony ZV-E10. If you're on a tighter budget and can live without a viewfinder, the Sony ZV-E10 is the best budget vlogging camera we've tested. Like the Fujifilm X-S10, it's part of a recent slew of vlogging-oriented mirrorless cameras. It has a fully articulated screen, a dedicated recording button, and a revamped internal microphone compared to photography-first Sonys like the Sony A6400. The lack of a viewfinder does make it a little less versatile, plus it doesn't feel as well constructed. But if you know you're mostly going to be shooting videos, the ZV-E10 is worth considering, especially at such an affordable price. If you want smoother camera movements, you'll need to use an optically stabilized lens or a gimbal since the camera doesn't have IBIS. Rolling shutter is also pretty bad on this camera, so be aware that it can introduce wobbling or distortion with quicker pans or camera movements. If you prefer a camera with better stabilization, a Micro Four Thirds option like the Olympus OMD EM10 Mark IV comes with 5-axis IBIS and falls in the same price range, making it a great value option for vlogging. The ZV-E10 still takes the cake thanks to its class-leading autofocus, larger sensor and microphone input, but if portability and stabilization are priorities, the Olympus is a solid alternative. Number 2. Canon EOS R5. If you've got budget to spare and are looking at the high end of camera tech, then we'd recommend considering the Canon EOS R5. It's a hybrid camera designed for both stills and video shooters, but its video features are some of the best in class. The headline spec is 8K at 30p, which is more than you need for YouTube, but this also gives you the option to crop in and get excellent 4K footage, or shoot in 4K natively and enjoy some of the best looking video you can get. You can even dial 4K up to a frame rate of 120 frames per second if you want. Canon's dual pixel CMOS 2 autofocus is one of the best systems in the business, and it works fantastically for video as well as stills. Video also benefits from in-body image stabilization, making it a simpler task to capture smooth footage while using the camera handheld. The burgeoning selection of RF lenses is also fantastic, with some of the sharpest optics around. And if you already have EF-DSLR lenses, then the EF to RF adapter lets you use them on the R5 with full functionality. It's not a perfect camera. It gained something of a reputation on release for its recording limits in high resolutions due to an overheating issue. It's not a crippling issue, just something to be aware of. As we made plain in our full review, this is still one of the most advanced and best cameras you can buy right now, full stop, and it's one of the most versatile buys that YouTubers can make. Number 1. Sony A7S III. It took Sony 5 years to upgrade the video-centric A7S II to a Mark III, but the wait was worth it for keen enthusiasts and professional filmmakers. It might not boast the 6K or 8K video resolution of some of its rivals today, and with only 12.1 megapixels, it's not a powerhouse super stills machine either. But apart from an extensive and expensive cinema camera, it's one of only a handful of cameras that can shoot 4K at 60p full frame with no crop, recorded internally in 10-bit 422 with no limitations on recording time, and with all the advanced AF functions still working. Instead of chasing headlines, Sony worked on giving filmmakers the camera they needed, with lots of codec choices without limits on frame rates, and uses its computing power for fast readouts to enable quick frame rates and high bit rates at all settings, with all other functions working, such as all the clever AF systems with eye and face detection for humans and animals, features that still shooters have come to take for granted, while video shooters have always had a crippled AF that just didn't offer all the bells and whistles. How should I choose the best camera for YouTube? The best camera for YouTube for you will depend on what type of video you're looking to share on your channel. If you want good quality video, then you'll want the ability to record in full HD 1080p. That said, many cameras now offer 4K, which YouTube now supports. You also want a camera that can adapt to different lighting settings, and check the camera's video length limit if you're planning to record long videos. Video isn't the only thing to consider, there's also sound. The best cameras for YouTube also offer excellent sound recording via a built-in microphone with noise cancelling capabilities, although you may still want to consider mics depending on the type of video you're producing. You also need to consider portability, because some cameras may prove to be too big and heavy if you're often filming on the move. In our selection of the best cameras for YouTube, we've included some good compact options that are convenient for carrying in a bag. So that wraps up our video of the best camera for YouTube. Hope that you found this video helpful, and if so, please leave a thumbs up, as I always appreciate that. Let us know in the comments down below which camera you're going to choose. Thanks for watching, and that's all for this video. If you like this video and it helps you in any way, please give this video a like, and if you don't want to miss out on any future videos, subscribe to the channel. Hope to see you in the next video. Till next time, see you guys later.